Hello guys, welcome all. My name is Amarnath Biswal and today we are going to synthesize four wire link mechanism by various methods. I will take four problems in that. The first problem reads out as design a four link mechanism to coordinate the following three positions of the coupler points. So what this question says is in the four wire link mechanism, we have input link, coupler link, and the output link, and one fixed link will be there. So the one point or one fixed point in the coupler link, they have given the three positions with respect to the fixed one end of the fixed link. So R1 given as means in a certain timing and position, they are given as 55, 70, 75 mm in the three different positions, and which will be rotated, and the outer means the output will be rotated by 75, 50, 40 degrees respectively because of this even location. And the input link rotation has been given as at a particular time 30 degrees and another particular time as 70 degrees. So let us start the problem. So our output diagram looks like this. Sorry for this disturbance. Okay. So our output drawing looks like this. This is my which has been drawn in a bold way, bold darker way. So here all the dimensions are in mm, and the scale we will take is 1:1. So we will start the problem is we will keep those data in mind, and first we will locate the suitable position of A1 in the horizontal line. Then what we will do, we will take the E1, E2 and E3 points. I will show you, this is E1, this is E2 and this is E3. So A1, E2 and A1, E3 distances should be equal to R1, R2 and R3 respectively. And you can refer that data given in the question to know the values of R1, R2 and R3. Now what we will do, as they have given alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3 as 70 whatever values have been given, you refer that. Okay, but they have given the input links, input link means input rotation. You know that our coupler link is a rigid body, so whatever point we will take on the even point will and rotate by how much amount, the input link will be rotated by say almost same amount. So here we will see, as I am seeing that means we are keeping this in mind, what we will do, we will take E2 point and rotate it by theta 1 2, and we will take E3 point and rotate it with theta 1 3. Refer that values, I will show you that values here. See, this is theta 1 2, theta 1 3, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. Alpha will be corresponding to what we will do in drawing A1, how we will draw the A1 even. Alpha 2 will be corresponding to R2, for which we will draw the A1, A2 point and line, and alpha 3 will be corresponding to R3, which we will draw for A1, E3. Okay, is this clear? Now we will, where I was, means we were drawing the, we were rotating the points by theta 1, 2, theta 1, 3. Okay, so after rotation by theta 1, 2 and theta 1, 3, we will get A1 E2 dash and A1 E3 dash, and A1 E2 dash and A1 E3 dash, these two points these two is a1 e2 dash sorry a1 e2 dash and a1 e2 length should be same, a1 e3 dash and a1 e3 length should be same. In easier ways you can draw the arc and the look means you can draw the arcs a1 e2 taking the radius as a1 e2 and draw the arc of taking the radius of a1 a3 and you can draw the similar lines as I've shown in the dotted line like this. Okay, up to that, now what you will do, you will take the perpendicular bisectors, how means to locate the v1. Prior to that we have to join e1 e2 dash in e1 e3 dash. For me it was obvious, so I didn't draw the a1 e2 dash in e1 e3 dash. So you should draw that. Okay, so what we will do, we will take the e1 e3 and we will perpendicular bisect it and draw the this line. You can see how it is going. You can see the cursor line, and we will draw again. We will take the e1 e3 dash and draw the perpendicular bisector like this thing, and we will join here at b1 and we will connect the a1 b1, and this our first half of the job is done. Next half will be to draw to locate the point c1. Okay, locate the point c1. For that, what we will do, we will rotate the a1 b1 by same amount as how we rotated a1 e2 dash and a1 e3 dash. Okay, so we will cut an arc which will we will draw an arc which will take the radius of a1 b1. Okay, and we will mark the b2 and b3 points and we join the a1 b2 and a1 b3 such that the angle between this line and this line should be theta 1 2, and angle between this line and this line should be theta 1 3. Okay, after this what we will do, we will join the b1 e1 point, b2 e2 point and b3 e3 point. Okay, after joining that, what you will take, I will take you through the steps. Okay, this is summary of what I told here. Okay, now we have to construct a triangle. So in this step it is saying to draw a constructed triangle e2 b2 d1 which is congruent to triangle e1 b1 d2. Okay, so we have to and e3 b3 d1 and e3 a1 b1 d3. Okay, so here we will go like this. Okay, so you must be thinking that how we locate a d1 point as yet, that's not mentioned. Don't worry, you can locate anywhere. Okay, but take suitable distance. Okay, so what after taking the d1 point, as it was saying, e2 b2 d1, so here it is our e2 b2 d2, this triangle I have drawn in a very lighter shade. Okay, so that my drawing does not look clumsy. So this triangle, you measure all the distances, copy it, and we will and take the reference of b1 e1. One point is that b1 e1, b2 e2 and b3 e3, these three lines should be of same length, because I previously told you these are part of your rigid body. If it is not same, you recheck your drawing again, start from the scratch. So we will take the b2 e2 for d1 point and b1 means